Hello and welcome to Minute News, bringing you the news that's often overlooked. Let's begin. As France moves forces into the Central African Republic, the Red Cross has collected 281 bodies from the 2 days of fighting in Bangui, but expect many more have been killed. Though France Charles was patrolling and to keep order in the country, residents and rights groups reported waves of killings in neighborhoods. The second report from Hong Kong about the H7N9 bird flu virus was announced, raising fears that the virus that has a mortality rate of 32% is spreading from mainland China. Egyptian security forces fired tear gas during clashes with rock-throwing supporters of the former President Mohamed Morsi earlier today. As anti-government protests persist in Kiev, Ukrainian President Yanukovych matched with Russian President Vladimir Putin in Sochi, Russia, on his return from meeting with China. Yanukovych said the talks were about trade and economic cooperation and preparation for signing a partnership deal. Anti-government protesters in Thailand set a deadline for bringing down the government, vowing that December 9th was the time for all of their supporters to join a final push for victory, though protest numbers have dwindled. It is unknown at the moment the measures that will be taken by the protesters. Despite public protests and criticism by the population, Japan enacts a state secret law toughening penalties for leaks and whistleblowing. Six men suspected of stealing a truck containing radioactive isotope, cobalt-60, has been detained and are in a hospital with possible symptoms of radiation poisoning. All the Syrian chemical weapons have been destroyed. The United States refuses to recognize China's new air defense zone. A cold air mass in the United States with ice an inch thick is impeding travel and cutting power, and a storm throughout northern Europe has taken 7 lives and thousands are left without electricity. That's it for Minute News. Check back tomorrow for more news every day.